Hey everybody, to the extent that you can have one, happy Monday. Today, we're playing Legend of the Mystical Ninja, Xenosaga, Super Brothers, and then we've got 4 hours of Zelda Spirit Tracks, which is the last blind playthrough of Zelda for me after having beat Phantom Hourglass last Friday. To the Zelda Symphony this weekend, they actually did a song from Spirit Tracks, it's pretty cool. Bit of Andrea's favorite Zelda song, which was, Dragon Roost Island. Encore songs. Ouch. Pretty rough right there. Hey, Yukubo. Okay. I love that this game series is just all over the place. Like, you turn a corner and you're suddenly in modern-day Japan. Kind of. There's very little distinction between when you're in the, you know, medieval feudal Japan areas. Ah, crap. Run out of, sandals here. Trying to get my yo-yo back. Easier said than done. We didn't get Battle of the Windfish, no. I'm good in the lottery. Favorite stage? Nice, dear. Yeah, this is pretty cool so far. I really, really, really like the sprites in this series. The character art is very unique. Looks really cool. Like I said last time, this kind of 16-bit style is my favorite graphical style for any video game. I would play games that looked like this until I died if I could get away with it. Welcome. Hi, come on in. Would you like something to eat? Yeah, let's get a burger. Alright. Yeah, they had all the clips. They had Koji Kondo, Miyamoto, and Aonuma. And I don't know, I want all the little Konami logos on the doors. I want all of those guys' lights to be green, is the way I'll describe it. I just hope they have happy lives. Especially Miyamoto, he's just a genuine, joyful person. And I think that's really cool. It's hard for me to imagine Miyamoto in a boardroom, like, really pissed off about something, right? Sure, it's happened, but... I'm pretty sure that they announced Majora's Mask 3DS at one of those Symphony of the Goddess events, because they ended one of them, like, he came out and said, oh man, there's gonna be a surprise, and then they opened the encore with a bunch of Majora's Mask 3DS footage. But imagine the audience would have been losing their shit if it had not actually formally been announced yet and just suspected. Got these Konami houses. No, Serp, I haven't. The only exception, somebody put it on the list. We did a Nintendo 64 free play day, and someone put one of the 64 Gomen games on here, and I was like, holy shit, these games are really good. So I definitely want to come back to the later Mystical Ninja titles. This is the Game Center. All games are $100. What do you want to play? I can play Gradius, really? Yeah. I renamed Gomen to Kid Ying. Is it really Gradius? They do something very similar. It's totally Gradius. That's awesome. They do this in Shenmue a lot as well. This is pretty rad. I'm trying to think, do any other Super Nintendo games do this? This is a pretty wild thing to include in your title. I wonder how much of Gradius is in here, too. Is it just, like, one level, do you think? A little Konami sign on the bottom. Oh, man, I don't think I've ever gotten this far at Legend of the Mystical Ninja, either. So this is my first time seeing this level, or seeing this section. I can see why this would be anyone's like favorite level, especially like if Kid Marston had gotten here. Holy crap, I would have lost my mind. Anytime there was any sort of crossover attempt would just freak me out as a kid. It's pretty common these days, but like getting the Culex fight in Super Mario RPG where it plays the Final Fantasy battle music blew my mind when I was a kid. It's good. No option for us. You get one life, and that's it. Cool. Yeah, we don't have to spend a ton of time here. Dieter paid to watch Mystical Ninja, not Gradius. That's awesome, Dieter. Let's see what else we got in these different houses here. Alright, this is another mini-game house. Let's do that right now. It's a good place for farming money because the enemies aren't particularly dangerous, unlike some of the other areas we visited so far. Why don't you keep a diary of your travels? Keep a diary, you'll be able to visit the places you've been to over and over. Yeah, let's do it. Oh, interesting. Alright. Like, he doesn't really keep his diary very efficiently, does he? He's worried about the CIA peeking his travel history or something. Yeah, this town's pretty awesome. I like the backgrounds, the design of the area, enemies. They give you a lot to do here, too. So, the Otafu Army Base is in the center of Yamato. That's true, Meter. I take it back. It's about as information dense as you can get. Using the characters available to Gummin. Welcome to the racetrack. Come on in. Alright. Do a racetrack. This one we haven't seen before. Oh, this is a variation on the lottery game. We'll move on. Excuse me. If you guys haven't checked it out yet, I highly recommend you go to raffle.marsta.com. It has a list of all of the prizes that are on offer for the raffle we're going to do as part of our 24-hour Super Mario Super Stream this Friday. Actually, can I back out of it? No, we can do this. Let's see what paint is. I think we did Goblin last time, or the Whack-A-Mole. Paint outside the lines. You've laid the paint on too thick, you're fired. Do your best. Like, what do they actually want me to... Oh, too thick means retracing the same line, sure. $25. Doing all right, Reapy Cheap. How you doing? Happy Monday. What's up? Throw three dice and guess no. It's cool that I have the option to do all these things, though. If it were Kid Me, I'd probably spend... Oh, that's funny. I'd spend most of my time in the area where you can play Gradius and some other games. That's awesome. Yeah, they put some effort into this. Nice. Alright, let's keep moving. Right, those guys have a big hitbox, it looks like. Be careful, stay away from them. Octorox! Wrong game. Whoa! See, an enemy looked just like this in Shantae. Guessing it was not a coincidence. Ouch. Come on, get the... There you go. Oh. Occasionally turns all the way around. There we go. Nasty. It's is a pretty cool bridge section. I like how each section of this game is just really different from the last one. It doesn't feel like a lot of modern games have this problem where it's like once you've seen a level, you know how the rest of the game is going to be. Dynasty Warriors is like that, for example. Once you've done one battle in Dynasty Warriors, it's not really going to change much from there. Not every game has to be done that way. Some rice balls. Dude, Pocky and Rocky is the shit, Serp. I've never beaten it because it's really, really hard, but that's my go-to, like, co-op game, two-player game to play with a friend on the Super Nintendo. One time we were on a long plane flight to go to PAX, me and Hey PAX, and we tried to get pretty far in Pocky and Rocky. I think we game over it on the fourth or fifth stage. But this kind of game is very similar to Pocky Rocky, absolutely. Mm-hmm. I will probably do a Pocky and Rocky playthrough on stream. I'll hopefully be able to do it two-player with Andrew. We might use a Game Genie code to give us infinite lives, because otherwise the chance of actually beating it is close to zero. Because it's so hard, and they give you so few lives, you really have to start all the way over from the beginning. Confused with Brave Fencer or Musashi. Everyone has their games I didn't play confusions. For me, it's any game that starts with a V, as in Victor. Vagrant Story, Valkyria Chronicles, Valkyrie Profile. There's a couple other ones that... Now I know what Valkyria Chronicles is, obviously. I played that on stream, but there's a couple of the ones that are V something. I have no idea what they are. I just never played them. Brave Fencer Musashi is a pretty rad game for the PS1. I look forward to doing that stream at some point. Dieter. So, you know, people have been filling out the subscriber survey that I sent out for people subscribing on Patreon. For the most part, I can't tell who did what, but I could tell Dieter's survey because he made a sub-block suggestion to the effect of every time someone subscribes, you should, like, point the camera down and perform prostrations and say a prayer. And say a number of prayers as a multiple of the number of dollars that they donated. I had a pretty good laugh out of that. Valda's story. Yes, that's the other one. There's several of them. Joe and Max, another really good one, little DPs. Actually, that's one that we beat on that same plane ride I was talking about, me and Apex. We beat Joe and Mac. We were trying to get through as much of Mario All-Stars as possible, I think. Like, actually playing through each of the levels. Goes the thief. Is the elites. Yeah, no song requests, sorry. Like an extra life? Looks like it. Pizza and one up. Pretty expensive though. Get some more sandals though, I don't want to run out of them. Yeah, I like to highlight the original game music, so. I haven't played Vagrant Story, no. Get the cat! There we go, look at that. Trying to think of a game where I might make an exception, but it's not really one coming to me. Those awful soldiers of the Otafu army defaced our great leader. Hey, Buckin, how you doing? Yeah, I've heard nothing but good things about it. Which is the one that's in Evilise? Is that Vagrant Story? There's like a, it's kind of an action RPG that's set in Evilise, so the same universe that Final Fantasy Tactics and Final Fantasy 12 are set in. It's by Square. Starts with a V. Never played it. Vagrant Story is the one? Cool. Got it right. Actually, only ever played Xenoblade X on stream the one time. We'll see if I get some extra time to play it. East, interesting. Ninja Star Tropics. I have some friends back in Ohio couple who are actually, if you see Cloud Reaver in chat, him and his wife are really into Star Tropics. And all I know about those games, I played maybe an hour of the first one for the NES, and I remember that it was one of the games that you needed to have the instruction manual to complete a certain part. There was like a fourth wall breaking thing that he used the manual for. Kind of like the check the back of the box puzzle in the original Metal Gear Solid. We did, oh, not supposed to hit the deers. Okay, lesson learned. We did Legend of the Mystical Ninja 64 for like 15 minutes on Nintendo 64 Free Play Day several months ago. And I really enjoyed it, having never played it before. Didn't know what I was in for. Actually, kind of makes me think of, man, those guys are really nasty. They're very hard to dodge. If you don't kill them immediately, you're in big trouble. I'm trying to get another... get my yo-yo back. They're among the most nasty enemies in the game, if not the nastiest. There's my yo-yo. Reminds me of River City Ransom. This part of the game, at least, anyway. When you're in the full-on, like, side-scrolling parts, a little bit less so. The letter that came with the manual, wow. Oh, I still take damage if I touch the deer? That's messed up. So I'm not allowed to attack them, but if I touch them, I get hurt. You work hard, I'll teach you my jutsu. You'll only be allowed to use jutsu in this zone. It'll be very valuable to you. Yeah, let's do it. Number one. Fight, fight! Hey, Six Gun, thank you for the follow. Appreciate that. It's good to have you. Fight, fight. Okay, so I have a special power now, and I think that's limited by the POW number that's there on the top of the screen next to the time limit. It seems like occasionally I can reset the time limit. Like, now it's at 99.99 again after I, or 999 after I went into that building. I don't know what drives that. I'm trying not to think too much about it. Find a switch, step on it with all your strength. Oh man. Like, don't just, like, lightly step on it. Oh god. No! See, that guy just kicks my ass when I see him. Fortunately, he doesn't spawn often here. He was spawning all the time a little bit earlier. Trying to get another cat. Oh, there's one. Gonna get to it in time. No! Damn, see? Two shot. GG. I'm gonna try to get to the next boss. This game seems to have a pretty reasonable checkpoint, like, continue system. Now, we'll go ahead and do whack-a-mole. I think the idea is we want to hit all of them. Let's do the fast course. Last time I thought that I was supposed to avoid hitting, our buddy. Aw, missed one. I think he might actually be worth the most points if you can hit him. Never played this game two-player, that would've been a lot of fun though. Maybe one day we'll play with Andrea. I like that this kind of punishes you for spamming the button. Like, once you pick a hole, you get a cooldown before you can attempt it again. Alright, made 40 bucks out of that. Pretty nice. Yes. Yep. Exactly, sir. There's actually several mechanics that are just like that. Like, having a score at the top of the screen is another one. Took a while for that to die. It's like, are we just doing this because of arcade games? Because it doesn't really make sense. Like, who cares about getting a high score in Super Mario Brothers? Primarily an objective-based game. It's like, let's beat the level, not let's compete for the highest score. Yes, a couple times, Bucken. Can't really schedule that, though. Why don't you keep a diary of your travels? Yeah, but I don't think it's actually a save, keeping the diary. Like, I would have to copy that down. That's what we got save states for. Is that effectively a password save game? Let you come back here from the opening screen without having to start all the way over? Alright, chain armor. I don't really figure out how to use bombs. We're gonna worry too much about it. We might want to get a one-up. It's expensive, but I'd rather not have to start this whole level over if we get hit by one of those guys who throws money at us. Welcome back, Burner. Yeah, we don't want to mess around with the deer. Yeah. This was the last generation to really use password systems in earnest. Nowadays, we typically have save games because memory cards and saving is pretty trivial. And maybe there were a couple in the 64 era that still used passwords. To know that memory cards weren't a launch thing at the 64. They were with the PlayStation and the Dreamcast. Remember, I owned Final Fantasy VII and a PlayStation 1 before I had a PlayStation memory card, so I had to play it as far as I could without game overing. Leave it on overnight. Most 64 game just saved the cartridge, Jim. Yeah, but it's the Tanuki. Look at his giant balls. Dangerous territory, be careful. Proceed with caution. Or it's not trivial to let you save to the cartridge. Like, by now, if you haven't already replaced the save battery in your old gold Zelda cartridge, it's very likely that it's died and you've lost your save. We had to do that. I picked up a copy of the NES Zelda for Andrea for her birthday the first year I met her, and save battery died within like a week. Crack it open and replace it. Not hard to do, it's just a watch battery, but that's a drawback to the original save system from back in the day. Does anyone know how they saved, because Zelda 1 was originally a Famicom Disk System game, not a NES game. So I don't know how saves worked in the original release of the game, if they did a password system or they had some other way to save. So we never got the disk system in the US. Come on, go, go, go. Yeah, right, Teeter. So you played all the other Final Fantasies, you didn't need to get a special thing to play with a save file. Up. Look at all that conveyance. Tell me where I eventually want to go. So I'm going to rotate this when we get to the place to do it. Like most games from this era, falling is like the worst possible thing that can happen to you. It's instant death. Okay, it's going to matter. Ow! It's going to matter later. We drop down here without falling onto the spikes? We can, but it's not trivial to do. Punch the naked dudes in the face. Or hash pipe.
That's pretty good conveyance. Show, don't tell.
There you go. Turn that down a little bit. Jump. 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 Ah, I thought that would count as a little platform. Today I learned, now I'm out of lives, so we'll see what happens when it lets me through this time. A Golden Sun did a password that lets you transfer between the titles, right? That was the whole idea. It sounded kind of like Oracle of Seasons and Oracle of Ages did the same thing, in principle. I'll try to get my yo-yo back before we move on to the boss fight area. We don't want to fall to our deaths now. Turns out that those spikes are not platforms that we can safely walk on. Okay. Dropping bombs from ceiling. Whole multiple layer thing here. Enabled by mode 7. Whoa. That was almost very bad. Yeah, that's actually very bad. We've got like one hit left in us. We only have one sandal. Do I want to leave? I think I'm going to leave and come back. So we don't have to start the whole level over. Though I suppose if we do, we can kind of beeline it to where we're supposed to go to progress. Like Gradius, this game has the whole don't make a mistake, because each mistake you make, it gets harder and harder for you to recover. You get a snowball benefit the longer you go with a set of power-ups, you know? Might be an area I could go to farm up more easily. I forgot he can do this. This is a weird game. Alright. I got a longer Hashif pipe. Opium pipe. Dane's failure indeed. That's cool, Spiky. They do have an official order in the timeline. If you Google Zelda Timeline Hyrule Historia, they're actually pretty important, because the theory is that the Zelda that's in Zelda 2 for the NES is the same Zelda that's in the Oracle games. But as far as like which of the two, which one to do first and second, I don't know. Probably do Seasons first, since it's more combat focused, and then do the puzzle one second. Save the best for last, kind of a thing. It happened coterminously. The reason for that theory about Zelda being the Oracle Zelda is that there are two Zeldas in Zelda 2, right? There's the Zelda that you rescue at the end of Zelda 1 for the NES, and then there's the sleeping Zelda that's been in like a coma or a curse for hundreds of years. That's the one that we think is the Oracle one. Good god, those guys are scary. Like, I feel like I'm gonna die as soon as I see them. Try to get back to the nearest shop here. I think it's marked as a shop. Hope so, anyway. Yeah, we can go and get some food at least, nothing else. Yeah, right, it affects. Best crawl animation. Everything is delicious here. Perfect. Yeah, let's go with... Oh, man. We don't need to walk out. We want to buy something. Goman's kind of a dick. Everything is delicious. Absolutely, yes. It's pretty expensive stuff. I don't know if it actually matters. I think you get full health no matter what. But it's just this kind of like... Maybe you want this cool avocado-y thing. Run away from the angry, balding man. Middle-aged man trying to kill us. Ah, shit. Alright, so I think that one of the other buildings that we skipped is a shop. So we're gonna keep going to the right here. I'm gonna try to avoid that guy. Unsuccessfully. Can open up a secret door, though. Look at that. By accident. What treasures might we find contained herein, you think? Ah. Yeah, let's plan on Seasons first. Let me just jump over this. Sure can, look at that. I think I need bombs to get to some of those chests. Probably need to be careful about just, like, opening those instantly. Can't get to that one without a bomb. The sandal drives that? That's a bummer. Yeah. Only have one pair of sandals. Not very American of me. And you get into a map that doesn't have any of those middle-aged dudes who GP toss you, guilt toss you to death. Oh no, I'll do both. I plan to do both of them. They're both very good games. Okay, let's not kill the deer. It takes our money away from us for some reason. This might be a store. No, it's video games. Sandal gives you faster move speed, and you get faster and faster the more of them you stack on top of each other, which, of course, makes sense. I'm No! Ah, alright, we'll see how far back it takes us. Game over. From logbook entry. Oh, so we should get the logbook entries. Alright, well now I know. So even though it looks like a password, the game actually does track whether you request it or not. So the last time we went to a travel agency, I didn't request one, and it sent us a little bit further back. But that's okay, we can still recover. Sonic 06. You can pick whatever you like for a sub-block. It's part of the magic. It doesn't necessarily have to be an awesome game that everybody loves. Play it for an hour. Don't need to beat it either, so you want to put on some crazy 200-hour game, knock yourself out. Now this game I could see just playing this on stream anyway, because it's really awesome. I'd like to beat it. This and like a host of similar, fairly short Super Nintendo games might be the focus of a future, like 24-hour stream. See how successful this one on Friday is. By the way, Friday, 24-hour Super Mario Super Stream. We're going to play as many Mario games as possible. You can check the 24-hour stream panel below the channel. If you scroll down a little bit, I updated it with the schedule of Mario games we're going to play, and you can go to raffle.marsed.com if you want to see what prizes we're giving away. Fabulous prizes. Donated thanks to Chaos Factor, also Kami, D-Rock, and Hapax. There's a choose-your-own-adventure book for Oracle Seasons. Really interesting. A lot of this game is figuring out where you're supposed to go next, so getting the setback that we had isn't actually that brutal. Yeah, sounds good. Among the prizes are some custom bead sprites, so you can specify a sprite that you want from any game, within reason. If it's got, like, a bajillion colors or something and it wouldn't be possible to do with a bead sprite, I'll let you know. We'll make those on stream. Hey, D-Rock, how you doing? Like to go find a shop, stock up on a bunch more sandals, maybe get that chain armor. Here's a story. They're just some dudes, like, riding on unicycles with parasols on their head, no big D. Yeah, let's get some sandals. Hella sandals. No, that's okay. I can get the travel agency to speed that up next time. I'm doing alright. Forward to the 24-hour stream this week. Thank you for your key donations. I went ahead and added them to the raffle spreadsheet. I think all these unmarked houses are just gonna have dudes that are giving us tips, so probably just keep moving. And they're like, their heads fall off, so they're like androids or something. Best not to question it. Welcome. We've been waiting for you. Will you be staying the night? Yeah, sure. Which room would you like? Let's do the suite. Yeah, no problem, man. I feel like if you need anything else, let me know. Happy to help. Oh, little D-Piece, it's awesome. They're so much fun. They're not very expensive, too. If you wanted to get into the bead spreading hobby, there's the little plastic bead video game characters you can see on the wall behind me. It costs maybe 20 bucks to start the hobby and get a starter perler bead kit. You just need to have an iron and an ironing board, aside from that. I played the Phoenix Wright Cornered music for Andrea the other day. Excited for that, with me doing Phoenix Wright on Thursday. Won the vote after we beat Uncharted. Let's try to keep the middle-aged guy from ruining us. It's pretty nasty. I still thought there was a shop down here that let us get chainmail, but it may have been somewhere else. I don't remember where. Went up there last time, no luck. Got the yo-yo back. There we go. That's right, you're gonna trip and fall. What happens when you mess with the best? This is, okay, this is the guy who does the games. Pretty stoked for Phoenix, right? Heck yeah. I'm going down first. Maybe there's a shop down here that I'm not inventing. Ah, damn you, friendly deer. Not nice. Sure will. I don't know if, like, picking a different room does anything, it doesn't give you a different cutscene. I've got the 3DS Phoenix Wright Trilogy, sir. Yeah, sure, D-Rock. If you want to, you can G-chat it to me. I'll take a look after stream. Or if you've got, like, an image or a link, go ahead and throw it in chat. Yeah, I don't know where the guy is that sells the chainmail, so we'll just move on into the dungeon area. Sometimes they're really easily marked, sometimes they're not. We're going to be playing Legend of the Mystical Ninja today for another 24 minutes. This is DDRX's sub-block game. Thank you for subscribing on Patreon. After this, we're doing Xenosaga from Cappy Man, 1006. And then Super Brothers from 4 to 5. And then from 5 to 9, it's Zelda Spirit Tracks, the last remaining Zelda game that's a true, complete blind playthrough for me. It's going to effectively be a blind playthrough, some of the ones like Zelda 2. It's been a long time since I played the Oracle games I played when they first came out a long time ago. Don't remember too much from them, but I truly have never played Spirit Tracks and have very little idea what I'm in for. Aside from the, like, boomerang boss battle that got completely spoiled for me at the Symphony of the Goddess Zelda concert we went to this past weekend. That was really cool. Yep, there sure is, Goomba. I picked it up actually back when Phoenix Wright has been on stream for an hour. D-Rock had this as sub-block game forever ago. That's what ended up getting it added to the main spreadsheet. Exactly. Was it swing your arms from side to side? Hey ho, let's go. Come on, do the Mario. They didn't really put a lot of effort in that show, did they? It's interesting how those spikes are more dangerous after you rotate the room. I'm just kind of giving you a heads up about it here. Probably not, Burner. The plan is to do, like, main series Mario titles. You can check the schedule down there under the 24-hour stream panel below the channel. It has a list of all the games we're going to play and in what order we're going to get to them. We're going to try to balance playing games we actually have a hope of beating, so the very short titles, like Donkey Kong, Mario 1, Mario 2 USA, Mario World, Mario 3, and the very, very long titles, which I'd like to check out, but we're not actually going to have any hope of beating, like Mario Sunshine. We'll start that for 2 hours. Okay, so we can't actually climb on that, even though it kind of looks like it. Oh god! Thanks a lot, Roland dude. I don't know how they would convey that differently, aside from having spikes on both sides of those platforms. We learned that the hard way last time, that you're not actually allowed to do that. Oh, we have to hit those guys twice, don't we? The arrow is actually pretty necessary from a conveyance perspective here. Otherwise, you would expect that you would die from falling there. Everything else about the game has told you that falling leads to death. We'll be doing both, Buckin. You can check the schedule there. It's listed. We'll do Mario 2 USA as part of the main schedule, and then one of the 2-hour blocks we'll do Mario 2 JP Lost Levels. Probably won't beat it. It's more like a 3-hour game, especially if you know what you're doing, which I don't. I think I've only ever beaten Lost Levels once. There's a couple pretty nasty teleports in that game. If you go to a warp center and it takes you back a couple levels, so there's a decent chance I'll run into one of those since I don't really know my way around it. This is pretty cool. It's that Mode 7 pseudo 3D. Jump. Not like that. At least he doesn't take falling damage. We have the same spiky platforms in Mystical Ninja 64. Interesting. Jump, jump. Time this a little better. Time this a little bit better, he said. You can ride on it, but you have to jump on it when it's at a very specific point on the pole, it looks like. There we go. That's the ticket. Junk! Okay, cool. Cool beans. Phew. That's pretty rough, actually. Doesn't look that intense, but it's actually kind of hard to land those jumps. No! Phew! Okay, let's just take it patiently. I don't need to get too excited. I'd like to get those things over here. I don't know what the, crap, can I get to that in time? Oh, I got some extra health. I don't know what the little, elephant statue that we have in the bottom corner does. Crawling. Do the worm. Oh, interesting, Dieter. Nice. Attention to detail and you knock that guy into the pit to kill him. Kind of want to get a longer opium pipe, but the risk is pretty high. Oh god, those guys take like 3 hits to kill? No shit. 4 hits? Dang, bro. That's rough. Alright, there we go. Golden pipe. Elephant statue's a checkpoint? Interesting. Yeah, the Battletoads level. The Battletoads level. We did finally beat that on stream. That was part of the NES free play day. With the aid of, oh wait, did we just loop around in a circle or is this a new room? Try to see if I can tell if this is different or if we just got turned around. I hope we didn't get turned around. This looks like the same room. And I'm pretty sure this is the same room. Alright, well, we'll try going out the left door this time, out the top, if this truly does loop around. Hear that, sir. Come on. Jump. Jump. There we go. This is like the hardest of the jumps in this section. Very easy to hit the spike. There we go. I know that made it not look that bad, but it was actually pretty bad. Take my word for it. Let's worm across. For a minute. Alright. Chill out here. Not to take any unnecessary damage. Alright. This is really the only way forward. I think we want to go left this time. Wait. Anyone know what the speedrun time is for this game? That's interesting to hear. Alright, nice. Yeah, you gotta really do a lot of anticipating on that one. You can't just, like, watch for it. Go. Gonna be hard. Nice. Okay. I'm going left this time. Hopefully that's progress. Yeah, this game is awesome. I love the music. Oh, interesting. Whoa! Make a bunch of naked dudes fall on my head. Not cool. Legend of the Mystical Ninja. So there's like a demonic slot machine in the back. More naked dudes falling from the heavens. Hell's bathhouse. Is it always gonna be a bad thing? Like, how do I get a good roll? Let's see how far back that puts me. Elephant. That's back in this room, isn't it? Okay, well, that's not too bad. Could be better, but... Jump? Jump? I might, just in the interest of time saving, hit a save state when we get to the top left corner of this room. Because this room is pretty nasty. My intent would be not to use it, but... There we go. Look at that. All kitties. That would be pretty nice. Dream. Right, this is definitely the way forward. We don't want to go right. Apologize to the anti-safe state gods. I wonder if their roll is truly random. Oh, maybe it is. I think that was different from last time. From having jumped on the same bot, or if certain like positions will get you better or worse rolls. You try to avoid most of them for now. I'm guessing there's some that you can't avoid. Let's see what we get. Nope. No. 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 Short weapon, too. That's incorrect. Don't think we can hit these guys. Oh, we have to hit them in the face. This would be a lot easier with the yo-yo. Whew. Got that worm crouch, man. Just bounce off the screen. Chunk! We're not done yet, are we? There's gonna be more to it than this. Oh god. Whoa! What the hell is this? Oh god. Mr. Potato Headed. This battle is insane. Well, like I said, interest of time, save state. Saving some time moving through that room we were just in. Yeah, right? Yeah. Farewell, Konami. We miss you. It's a bummer. They were, like, Konami and Capcom were the two third-party developers back in the day, you know? Kitties! Alright, that's what I'm talking about. Cool. I have a better chance at this. Yeah, right, snake behavior. Guess they just... It's almost worse that they don't even do anything with games anymore. This might actually be harder with the... Because you have to stand in a more dangerous position, I guess. Eh, we'll see. I'll probably want to have it for the second phase. Sunsoft. What are some Sunsoft games? That doesn't ring a bell for me. Bad one I remember was LJN, the rainbow. This boss is so weird. Looks like hitting him knocks him back, so you can keep him far away from you. Freaky! Oh, now he's pissed. Aww! We're doing so well. I'll try it again. Not gonna have the... Unless we get lucky and get... three, kitties again. It's one of those, like, you feel like you almost do better when you have the shitty item. There's the kitties. Look at that. Nice. All right. You almost do better when you have the shitty item because you're forced to play more carefully. Blaster Master. Yeah, that game is awesome. Do they do anything after Blaster Master? Batman NES is pretty good. Mm-hmm. Back in the day when licensed games weren't necessarily terrible. Like, DuckTales is in the same boat. There's still a few modern exceptions to that, like the Batman Arkham titles are quite good. Okay, come on, dude. Mm-hmm. Tiny Toons game for the Super Nintendo is pretty good. Died out during the Super Nintendo, gotcha, yeah, yeah. Okay. We gotta watch out when it gets Super Potato Head stage. This boss becomes really hard. I do like the bosses in this game. They're just completely out of nowhere. You gonna chase him this time, is what got us killed last time. We'll see if he uses the same attack pattern when he comes back now, or if he changes again. It's getting slowly bigger and bigger. God. Phew! That was nasty. Okay, right on. I am Ninja Woman, yay. Hey, girl. Oh, I never had those, Chaos. That's awesome. There's a lot of NES games with really good music. There are some games that are terrible, but they have music that almost sort of redeems them. Silver Surfer for the NES is one of the worst games for that system, but it only had like two songs, but the two songs in it are really radical. You should Google Silver Surfer NES stage music. It's probably the most dense NES music I've heard that was actually designed for the system. Some people have used Famitracker since then, like chiptuners, to write their own music that's quite a bit more dense, obviously, but it's pretty crazy what they were able to fit onto the chipset back then. Yeah, it was apparently a boss. Hey, King Fen, how you doing? Was Gimmick a late NES release? I don't know, I've never heard of it before. What kind of game is it? Man, hitting me with baby bullets? That is on the list of things I ain't trying to hear. This would be a good stopping point to just being on this stage for when we play next time. Nice, T-Rock. We had pet birds. We had a parakeet. Cockatiel. 2D platformer with physics. Interesting. Oh man. Those guys are almost as bad as the middle-aged dude who throws money at you, gill tosses you. Nah, I'm good. They have the advantage of you just don't want to be on the same plane as they are, and you should be fine, but if we're fighting them on, like, this bridge, that's going to be quite a bit harder to pull off. Probably just try to avoid them, maybe kill them from below if possible. Only came out in Japan and Scandinavia. Wow. Sure will. Damn, that's sweet. Health back. It's one of those where it's probably correct if you come into this level without any lives to just let yourself die. Get your lives back right at the beginning, because otherwise game overing will take you back too. But we'll keep pushing forward. Mission of discovery. And Link to the Past Death Mountain over here. I wonder if there's anything down that little path there. Suspicious design. Nope. Can I just sit here and farm pigs? Get the items I need? It's certainly safe, if not fast. It's always good. I want to do this until I get my yo-yo back. There we go. I wonder if there's a place you could stand where you could hit multiple and just keep respawning them. Possibly. Dude's hat off. I'll have to check out this gimmick game. I've never heard of it before. I'd love to see a modern take on Blaster Master. That game was so cool. I don't know how the rights to it work. The company's defunct. Blaster Master kind of sort of had the, I guess the umbrella protects me from bombs falling in my head. That's kind of cool. I was wondering what it did. I got it forever ago. Kind of had the Metroidvania thing going on before it was a big deal. Named thing. Trip World. Yeah, wow. I never had an OG Game Boy as a kid. My first Game Boy was a Game Boy Color. I think it was Pokemon at the time. I had a Game Gear, which was the incorrect decision. Game Gear's primary function was to eat AA batteries. You put like 8 AA batteries in the back and then ate them in the space of a few hours. Ninja Stars, man. Ooh, we can throw at angles. Good to know. Doesn't look like I can actually kill them. I mean, I can damage them so that they fall down, but I don't know if I can get any stuff off of them, I should say. Crazy ninja stage. Up your head in the ceiling. This might be one of the most, like, comedy-focused video games I've played. Maybe you guys can think of another example. Not just a game that's... also has some humor, but I feel like a good chunk of the game is that it's funny. Bummer. Cool, perfect. I think this will be a good stopping point. We're not gonna be able to get much further from here, so let me go ahead and pause it and save state. So we started a couple minutes early, and we'll take a couple minutes to get Xenos Saga spun up. If you just joined us today for Legend of the Mystical Ninja, welcome. Hey, I'm Marstead. I'm trying to beat every awesome game ever made live on Twitch. And on Mondays, we do a subscriber block where we just try out games recommended by subscribers on Patreon. This is one of them. This is the second time we played Mystical Ninja. If you wanted to check out the first part of the playthrough, it's on YouTube. This will go up there, too. And I would expect to see more of this game. We'll keep playing it till we beat it. All right, give me a few minutes to get Xenos Saga set up. That's the next sub-block game. Throw up BRB.